Hi, Jeff Brumfield with Nature Magazine. You said, as a layman, I think we have it. So what would you have us write today? Have you found the Higgs or what?
As a layman, I would say we have it. But as a scientist, I have to say, what do we have? We have something, yeah? We have discovered a boson. And now we have to determine what kind of boson it is. That's in the scientist's language, so to speak.
I'll just jump in. It's Ian Sample on the Guardian in London. Can you tell me, how far do you expect to get in finding out more about this particle before you shut down temporarily at the end of this year? How much further do you think you'll get in understanding what this is?
So it's quite early, as you know. We're just seeing this thing emerging, and it's difficult. I showed some very early measurements. But we've done some projections and some studies to see, could we tell if it was a scalar, for example, or a pseudoscalar? And we're hoping that with the additional running, we might reach the point by the end of the year with the combination of both experiments to sort of separate that sort of information, for example. We also hope to see a lot more information in the various channels and see that those balance out correctly. But to say definitively that it is a standard model Higgs would be very difficult.
My question is to Professor Higgs. If you could comment as a layman, as a scientist as well, what is his impressions? Would he say we got it?
I think it's not appropriate for me to answer any detailed questions at this stage. This is an occasion celebrating an experimental achievement, and I simply congratulate the people involved.
John Halpern, Associated Press. Will you follow this up with a formal announcement at some point that you have not just found a Higgs-like boson, but you have found the Higgs boson? And if so, when might that be?
Well, I think you have to define for me what is the Higgs boson. If you mean the standard model Higgs boson, then we can answer that question at some stage, but that will take time because, as I said, you have to investigate the properties. Because take supersymmetry. Supersymmetry requires a low-mass Higgs boson. And we have a low-mass Higgs boson. But it requires four more, at least in the smallest extension of the standard model, four more Higgs bosons. And one of them could also be, again, pretty low mass, and it could, these low mass Higgs bosons could have slightly different properties compared to the standard model Higgs boson. And this we have to find out.
I think we have to be a bit patient. We need to do the needed scrutiny work to understand well with what we have seen.
Tom Clark here from Channel 4 News. I'm trying to get an idea of how similar the particle that you've now discovered is to the one described by Peter Higgs and his colleagues sitting right next to me.
We can only say whatever we see, but it's consistent with a Higgs boson as it is needed for the standard model. Take this picture, you suddenly, far, far away, you see somebody. You think you know that person, yeah? Ah, it's your best friend. But you have to check, is it your best friend or is it your best friend's twin? For this person has to come closer, closer, closer. You can compare this, we take data more and more and more, and then we can compare the shape. And then we finally see, is it that one? Or the other one. I said last year, we will make a discovery. Done. I said, we will either exclude the existence of the standard model Higgs boson, the existence of the standard model Higgs boson, we have not excluded it, or we will discover the existence of a Higgs boson. But there, if you read, then you can see I did not use the word standard model Higgs boson. Because in order to pin it down, it needs time. This is a boson, and therefore we can call it a Higgs boson, but we can only call it a Higgs boson and not the Higgs boson. That's the difference.
It's Nick Collins from the Daily Telegraph. Do you think that Peter Higgs and the other men sitting to my left deserve a Nobel Prize for this?
This is a question to the Nobel Prize Committee. I can only say it was a fantastic achievement what they had, And we are not for nothing looking for this famous particle since many, many years, because we took it very serious. But I don't give you any opinion, but it was a great work.